or video. If you would like to download the free manual that follows along with this video, the link is in the description below.
For our next session, we want to look at the P6 hierarchy. When you open your P6, generally by default, P6 will open up a project. But before we get started with the project, let me just give you a general overview of the P6 hierarchy. In P6, there are four levels of basic hierarchy. Your initial level is the Enterprise Project Structure, the EPS. This is the highest level in your organizational project structure. This allows you to organize your projects based on how your organization is structured. Within each one of those EPS nodes, you can store all of your projects. That's the second level of your EPS, or your P6 hierarchy. The next level of hierarchy is the work breakdown structure. And then within the work breakdown structure are the individual activities or your schedule. Let's take a look at how that works in P6. You'll notice I have my projects open. This is a list of my projects, and they are all stored within my enterprise project structure. I can summarize these to give you an overview of how this particular EPS structure is organized. Now, to organize your EPS nodes, you go to Enterprise, Enterprise Project Structure, and the EPS Node Organizer opens up in a window. You can see the hierarchy in this window. It is the same as is shown over in my Project Organizer. You can see I've got Enterprise, E&C, Energy Services, Manufacturing. See, this is all the same hierarchical structure over in this window. I can organize these and all of my projects move with it. For example, on the left, I have LOB1, LOB2. If I want to move LOB2 up, you see these buttons over on the right-hand side. I can hit the up button and notice my LOB2 moved up above my LOB1. You can move it back by selecting it. A couple of things to note. These arrow buttons over on the right-hand side, you might as well get used to those. Throughout this training, you will be using those for various different components of the P6. So to add a EPS node, it's very simple. I can go under E&C. I can add an EPS node. I'm going to call it Schools, School Construction. And I want to make that a subcategory under my engineering and construction, so I can move it to the right. Now, when I close this and I open up my engineering and construction, there is my new EPS node, School Construction. Once again, that's in the Enterprise Project Structure. From within this window, I can add, delete, move any of the EPS nodes that I want to have in my organization. Keep in mind, all of my projects are stored within one of these. So if I delete one, all of the projects get deleted with it. However, the convenience of it is if I move these, all of my projects move with it. So it's an excellent way to store your project schedules and organize them and keep them for easy access.
Don't forget to like and subscribe, share with your colleagues, and leave a comment. We'll get back to you as soon as possible.